I want to start this video by saying, I'm a gamer. Do you know what that means? It means I can do whatever the fuck I want, baby. I'm unstoppable. Being a gamer isn't a hobby to me. It's a responsibility. And as the saying goes, with great responsibility comes great power. So, when I remember Drake's Fortune is the only Uncharted game I haven't finished on crushing difficulty, I knew it was my responsibility to fucking do it. So I turned on my PS4, started the Nathan Drake collection, and selected a new game. I wanted to pick the brutal difficulty, but it was locked. Thank God it was locked! So I chose crushing and... it was a terrible mistake. I underestimated this game's crushing difficulty. It was personal now. I had to finish it. I had to prove that I was still worthy of being called a gamer, goddammit! Now let's talk about crushing difficulty. On other Uncharted games, doing a crushing run is hard. It can be a pain in the ass sometimes, but it's pretty doable. Unlike its sequels, Uncharted 1 has some... problems that make its crushing difficulty an agonizing and painful thing to do. It's like playing Cyberpunk on a base PS4. Even worse, it's like playing GTA Online on any platform. Believe me, it's something you don't want to experience in your lifetime. So, what are the problems I'm talking about? You can die instantly if you try to throw a grenade. In cover! You have to deal with enemies that can tank multiple bullets and even dodge them if they want to. What is this, fucking Matrix? Sometimes the music stops playing in the middle of combat, making you think it's over. Then bam, surprise motherfucker, some random asshole comes out of nowhere and blasts you with a fucking shotgun. Do you like to stealth kill your enemies in video games? Well, you better forget about it, because Uncharted 1's stealth mechanics are even more useless than the jump button in Last of Us 2. The climbing is extremely clunky. Sometimes Nate won't grab anything after you jump. Sometimes you make the jump, but he rolls and falls to his death. I like to think Nate was just suicidal in the first game. Now that you know the problems of this game's crushing difficulty, you are ready, my children. Allow me to take your hands to an adventure and tell you a tale full of screams, deaths, and of course, rage quits. The first chapter takes place entirely on a boat. You have to defend yourself against a bunch of pirates. Simple, right? This is gonna be fun. This one actually doesn't have any fights, so we're gonna skip it. Now, this chapter has the first real fight of the game. You have to kill multiple groups of enemies as you're escaping from a temple, and it's... well, it's not easy to kill them. This is where boys become men. I tried to stealth kill the guys in the first group, but every time I killed the first guy, the rest of them would miraculously find out about it and avenge their fallen comrade. After a few deaths, I gave up trying to be Agent 47 and killed them with my guns. After that, I killed this guy and both of his friends after him. Then I got to the Stairs of Death. I like to call them that because every time you walk up those stairs, a bunch of enemies will shower you with bullets. After dying what felt like 200 times, I managed to kill those guys and get to the next group. A spoiler alert, they also killed me a lot. Finally, I managed to get past them. I thought that shitty fight was over, but there was one group left. The worst thing about this group is that they're scattered everywhere and you can barely see them. After dying a good number of times, I realized the best strategy is to shoot them from the entrance pit. It was really hard to see the enemies from the pit, but I managed to kill one of them and injure another. Then I rushed out of the pit and killed the weakened guy and his friend. Chapter 3 was finally over. Oh god, it's time for chapter 4. This motherfucking agonizing torture of a chapter is probably the hardest one in this game. It has so many hard fights one after another that it's mind-numbing. It doesn't give you any breaks. Even thinking about this chapter makes my blood boil. Chapter 4 starts with Nate parachuting out of a plane and into a jungle. After a little walk, I reached the first combat encounter of this chapter. There were only 3 pirates in this encounter. It's supposed to be easy, right? It wasn't. The torment and misery these 3 motherfuckers inflicted upon my soul nearly broke my spirit. I just couldn't kill them. It was so frustrating that I couldn't even cross this tree trunk without dying. After a dozen deaths, I finally managed to kill them. Then I climbed up this branch and a bunch of guys started attacking me, and of course, kill me. Guess what happened next? I had to kill those 3 assholes again! Fuck, kill me, please. To my surprise, it only took me 2 tries to get past them this time. I killed the rest of the enemies and proceeded to the next shitty combat encounter. This is one of the easier ones in Chapter 4, but it has a lot of enemies. I almost did it first try, but the game's clunky covering mechanics said nah, let's fuck this guy. I was lucky though, because I had already activated a checkpoint in the middle of the fight, and it helped me finish it quickly. Then I got to Chapter 4's next shitty combat encounter. Now if you're not quick here, some of these guys will rush you like there is no tomorrow. After a few tries, I cleared the first section of this area. Then I died like an idiot. And of course, I respawned at the very beginning of the fight. I can't even be mad at this. Alright, I cleared the area. And decided to do this. I got on this rock and spent more time than I'm willing to admit trying to figure out where to go next. But come on, how the fuck was I supposed to know blowing up this barrel would make the truck flip 25 times in the air and make a new path for me? This is the type of shit that happens in a Fast and Furious movie. After jumping on a bunch of rocks and killing a couple of enemies, I got to another shitty combat encounter. It has all the problems I mentioned with this game's crushing difficulty at the beginning of the video. This 2-part fight has fucked me in every conceivable way. After dying a shit ton of times and failing to kill myself, I just rage quit. But I came back the next day. I tried to play smarter this time, because you know, I'm a smart gamer. So I threw a grenade before shooting any bullets. It didn't kill anyone. Someone flanked me and I died. This time I focused on killing the guys to the right first, so I wouldn't have to worry about people shooting at me from 2 directions. Then I killed the rest of them to my left. I moved forward a little. I thought the fight was over because the music stopped, but a bunch of enemies spawned at the other side of the map. Luckily, there was a cover near me, so I managed to complete the first part of the combat encounter and trigger a checkpoint. The next part begins. Now at that point, I didn't know I was in a combat section. Because there was no music! So a shit ton of enemies spawned behind me and took me down. I hate it. I hate this chapter. After respawning, I used my pistol to kill enemies at long distances. You see, the pistol is one of the best weapons in Drake's Fortune. It has high accuracy and it deals a lot of damage. It's like a fucking sniper rifle. It's a gamer's wet dream. After running out of pistol ammo, I moved forward and killed someone with my AK. Then I ran out of AK ammo as well. It's safe to say at this point I really didn't know what the fuck to do. I panicked. Luckily, the last guy didn't rush me like a Terminator, so I killed him with one of my grenades. I thought it was over, but the combat music kicked in again and the game spawned a ton of enemies at the other side of the area. I used my sniper rifle and killed 2 of them with it. I threw a grenade at that pillar as part of my strategic plan to distract and kill the remaining pirates. Then I expressed my happiness by doing this. It's time for the last shitty combat encounter in Chapter 4. I wanted to kill all the enemies like some kind of silent assassin, but after killing the second guy, they somehow figured everything out and I nearly died. Pretty good start. I used the AK and killed them. The music stopped, but new enemies spawned and killed me. when I was throwing a grenade in cover! To my surprise, I didn't have to kill the guys at the beginning again because of a checkpoint. I killed all of the pirates except two because I ran out of ammo. One of them was getting close, so I said fuck it and killed him with my bare hands. I miraculously didn't die. There was only one pirate left. I got out of cover to pick up some ammo, but he threw a grenade, so I had to fall back. Then I started shooting at him. Don't dodge my fucking bullets, you piece of shit! The fight was basically over, but I got killed by a fucking trap and had to do it all over again! Fuck! I used the fucking grenade launcher I found on the ground and killed all of the enemies with a combination of explosion and setting off those fucking traps. And that marks the end of this horrible chapter. The Fortress is a short and easy chapter. Well, for the most part, because it has one of the hardest combat encounters of the game. The infamous Blue Room fight, where enemies spawn in every direction with shotguns that can instantly kill you at close range. It's complete mayhem. You have to be ready for anything. Constantly looking over your shoulder. It is considered by many the hardest part of the game. I did it first try. I told you I'm a smart gamer. Unlocking the Pass is also a short chapter. It has like two combat encounters, but the first one is really tricky. And that's because most of its cover spots are complete shit. There are two pirates on the wall that are pretty hard to kill but can easily kill you. This isn't the hardest part though. After you kill those guys, you have to climb up some stairs. That is when a new group of motherfuckers spawn and it's highly likely they'll kill you because you don't have enough time to take any cover. And the worst part is, every time they kill you, you have to kill the pirates in the beginning again. I tried a lot of strategies. I tried taking cover here, tried killing them as soon as they spawn, tried coming down the stairs and taking cover behind the jeep, I even tried going back to my respawn point. None of these fucking worked. And every time I had to deal with the beginning enemies again. Hey, this part is just broken. On my next attempt, I immediately jumped down from the stairs and killed the first two motherfuckers. Then I carefully walked up the stairs and took cover behind a crate and killed the final motherfucker with a headshot, baby.
How much trouble could one girl be?
I've got balls of steel.
This one is entirely a chase sequence. It's clunky as fuck, so I died a couple of times doing it. Alright, I died more than a couple of times. Alright, check this out. That guy killed me 1 millisecond after I came out of cover. Now look at this. He fucking did it again! Alright, third time's a charm. Crushing difficulty. What a joke. Oh boy, yeah. This is the first jet ski section of the game. In these sections, you have to drive this piece of shit and also kill the enemies that attack you from every building without having any covers. I remember these parts sucking ass even on normal difficulty, so this is gonna be a lot of fun. God, I hate this game. After finishing the first jet ski section of the game, I arrived at a new area and there is a combat encounter in the beginning that I hate with a burning passion. I despise this fight.
and it's just because of one single enemy at the end. You see, this guy has a fucking magnum, so he can one-shot kill you before you even see the fucker. Who is this guy? Deadshot? It took me like 6 deaths to even understand what was happening. I thought it was some kind of fucking glitch. Every time you fail, you have to kill 12 enemies to get to him again. And it's not like it's easy to kill those guys. To prevent myself from losing my sanity, I took a break and decided to do healthier things than playing Uncharted 1 on crushing difficulty. Like jerking off to some good old Danny Daniels videos, haha! I came back the next day and discovered one of the greatest things Uncharted 1 has to offer. The brilliant Donut Drake skin. It must have some kind of divine gamer power because after activating it, I finally killed the Magnum guy. First try, baby! Alright, it's time for Chapter 9. Yeah, about that. You see, Chapter 9 starts with the second jet ski section of the game, which are some of the worst parts of Drake's fortune. And after that, there are a bunch of hard and annoying combat encounters. By the time I finished all of them, I was so angry and frustrated that I didn't even save the recording of these parts. I'm sorry, I just gave up, alright? I didn't think I was gonna finish this. But after a few days, I remembered that I could never forgive myself if I didn't finish this shit. My gamer pride was on the line, goddammit. It wasn't about winning. It was about sending a message. I stopped playing a little bit into Chapter 10, so this is where we're going to continue. In this segment, you have to jump on some platforms while avoiding gunfire. After jumping on the last platform, I had a little brain fart and didn't see the lock I had to shoot on the door in front of me. So I just jumped and hoped for the best. Not a good plan. On my next attempt, I shot the lock, but pressed X too late, so I died again. What is wrong with me? It's good to be back. The first combat encounter of Chapter 11 takes place in a big-ass area, and there is a good reason for that. There are a lot of bad guys here. I held my ground behind this cover and started killing them. I couldn't go anywhere else because there was some asshole up there shooting at me. After killing most of the guys on the ground, I finally shot him and moved forward to kill the rest of them. After killing a guy with a minigun, I went back to my first cover and killed the last enemy. Then an entire gang spawned behind me and fucking killed me. How the fuck was I supposed to know this would happen? After doing this fight, your next goal is to find a new jet ski. Yay, another one of those. There are a few tricky enemies on the way, but nothing too bad if you're patient enough. Chapter 12 starts when you find the jet ski. The only good thing about this jet ski section is that it's the last one. Here, you have to go against the water flow, which is really annoying because of the clunky controls. Also, you have to shoot the pirates at long distances if you want to have a chance. Oh, I forgot to mention, there are a fuck ton of explosive barrels in the river. Yeah. They really wanted to make this as fun as possible. After heading upriver a little, I reached the first enemy, but he was no match for Donut Drake. After nearly dying by this barrel, I encountered 3 new enemies. I had to kill them from a really long distance with my sniper rifle. A little bit later, I got to an area with a lot of bad guys, so I did what any rational person would do. I tried to run past them like a fucking madman. Not a good plan. But on my second attempt, I took my sweet ass time and killed them one by one at long distances. And before long, the last jet ski section of the game was over. It was surprisingly easier than the other two. Now, Sanctuary is the chapter where the game gets a lot easier. Why? Because I found out that if you don't get into cover, but instead aim at the bad guys from behind it, you can shoot them. but they can't shoot you. It is the ultimate trick, the definitive gamer move. It's like unlocking a cheat code in real life. The next fight was a breeze with this trick. I got to a gate which you need Alina's help to open, but the game doesn't tell you that. So I was pressing triangle like a fucking idiot, thinking my controller was broken. After a while, I remembered I had to blow up those barrels to get to Alina.
Nice cock. Perfect.
We opened the gate, and after a few easy combat encounters, we got to a room where you have to solve one of the worst puzzles in the series. To this day, I still can't solve this puzzle on my own, even after watching the solution on YouTube. Like, what the fuck is this supposed to mean? Fuck off, game! This puzzle sucks ass. Nothing too interesting happens in these two chapters except some bullshit climbing deaths. You might have noticed I'm completely skipping some fights lately. Well, that's because the cover exploit made most of them a piece of cake, baby! Chapter 16 has a lot of platforming. And since this game's platforming is shit, you have to deal with phenomena like this. After the platforming is over, Eddie and his gang of bullet-dodging rat fuckers show up to ruin your day again. It's gonna be over soon. Just a few more chapters. Chapter 17 introduces these lovely fellows as a new type of enemy. Contrary to how they look, they are not that tough to kill. So I'm gonna skip the two chapters that feature them as the main bad guys. There is a huge battle in chapter 19 between Nate, Roman's men, and the monsters. I really like this fight. It's so epic and not that hard. Except for the beginning. If you're a patient guy, you can just wait for the monsters and the humans to kill each other, then kill the remaining enemies. I know that's what I did. Race to the Rescue has a few combat encounters, but at this point, those kind of fights shouldn't be that hard for the player anymore. Do you know what was hard? There is only one combat encounter in this chapter, and it's agonizing. I didn't try to take a shortcut this time, so I used the path the game had chosen for me like a good boy. I killed the monsters. Then this guy showed out of nowhere and blasted me into oblivion. On my third attempt, I took my time and killed the enemies one by one. I took cover and killed the shotgun dude and his buddy, but then the helicopter flew away. It was a timed sequence. Are you fucking kidding me? This was my last attempt. I'd either do this or turn off the console and try it later. I kinda fucked up the beginning part with the first few monsters, so I thought I wouldn't make it, but kept playing anyway. I waited for these fuckers to come out of the water so I could kill them as fast as possible. I used the cover exploit and killed the assholes with shotguns and jumped on the statue. The final chapter is Naughty Dog's last effort to send me to Arkham Asylum. It is extremely hard, and by hard I mean bullshit. It is probably the worst chapter in Uncharted 1, and that is saying something when chapter 4 exists in the same fucking game.
So the entire chapter is basically a boss fight. You have to move between covers and kill Navarro's men to proceed to the next area. But it's hard to do that when there are six guys mercilessly shooting at you like you stole their fucking Fortnite Weebucks or something. After slowly killing Navarro's men, I got to the next area. Now this is where shit gets interesting. Because somehow the enemies are even more aggressive than the ones from the first area. Before I could do anything, Navarro one-shotted me and the game respawned me in the first area. Fuck. I got to the second area again and killed the bad guys, but before I could even express my happiness, the game spawned an entire battalion of enemies in front of me. Then the boss fucking one-shotted me. That is just amazing. After dying many times, I got sick of this game's shit, so I tried to use the cover trick. I still died a lot, but I didn't give up. Suddenly, I became an anime protagonist, and through the power of friendship and cover exploiting, I killed all of my enemies. There was only one task left to do. Navarro's QTE sequence. My heart was beating fast. My hands were shaking like an angry Rockstar fan after he sees another GTA 5 trailer 8 years after release. My torment was almost over. I could finally... I'm gonna fucking kill myself if it respawns me at the first area.
Woo! Yeah, baby! That's what I've been waiting for! That's what it's all about! Woo!
I can't believe Naughty Dog didn't fuck me over this. And just like that, it was over. I might not have walked on the moon or found the cure to cancer, but I finished Uncharted 1 on crushing difficulty. That journey was hard and painful. I swear, cutting your own penis is a more enjoyable experience than playing Uncharted 1 on crushing difficulty. I'd rather play an Uncharted ripoff than to replay Uncharted 1 on this difficulty.
Which makes me wonder, how the fuck is there an even harder difficulty in this game?